Hello everyone, Zeus on this side. So today hand we are starting with a topic called as locomotion and movement. So basically we'll be dealing with the introductory portion of the chapter and then we'll be going for the further details. So let's get started. So here the movement is basically one of the significant feature of the living things. Okay, because the animals as well and the plants as well, both of them exhibit a wide range of movements. Correct? Okay, for example, the streaming of the protoplasm in the unicellular organism like amoeba as well. So basically the streaming of the protoplasm is also called as cyclosis. Okay, and the meaning of the cyclosis is it is the movement of the fluid or the movement of the cytoplasm within the cell is called as cyclosis. It can be happened in the normal cells as well, which means the be it plant cell and be it animal cell as well. Okay, now the movement of cilia as well, the movement of cilia, the movement of flagella and the tentacles. Okay, so the movement of the cilia will be in the paramecium. Yes, the cilia helps in the movement of the food through the cytopharynx. And the second one is called the flagella. Yes, the flagella is present in the bacteria. So you can go for that case as well. And the tentacles, yes, the tentacles are present in the hydra for capturing the prey. Okay, deal with the case. Now the human beings can move the limbs. It can move the jaws as well, eyelids as well, and the tongue as well. Specifically, if I'll be telling you that right now I am moving everything whatever has disclosed here, the limbs, jaws, eyelids and the tongue, all of them. Okay, now some of the movement result in the change of the place or the location, and that voluntary movement is called as locomotion. So deal with the case. If I'll be going for the difference between the movement and the locomotion, I have to go for, if I'm dealing with the locomotion, I have to change my location. Majority of the time, like the first three letters are same in the locomotion and the location. So if I want to locomote from one place to the other place, I have to change my location. Correct? Okay. And if I am not changing my location, but still I am moving my limbs or my jaws or my eyelids or my tongue, that will be called as only as movement. Okay? Deal with. If I am not changing my location, but still I am moving my body, that will be called as movement. And if I am changing my location along with the movement in my body, that will be called as locomotion. For example of the locomotion will be the walking, running, climbing, even flying as well. So walking, yes, we can show walking as well, we can show running as well, we can show climbing as well, we can show swimming as well, but we can't show flying. Okay, so please do not try this at home or at school or at anywhere. And this was a tagline way back when I was a kid in the WWE shows. Now so basically, there are some forms of the locomotory movement. The locomotory structures need not to be different from those affecting other types of the movement. For example, here, in case of the paramecium, we have already dealt about the case in that the cilia helps in the movement of the food through cytopharynx. Okay, and at the same time, simultaneously, cilia is helping in the locomotion as well. Whereas the hydra can use its tentacle for capturing the prey. Yes, we have dealt this topic as well, that the tentacles can be used for capturing the prey as well and for the locomotion as well. So here we can go for like the two parallel functions. The same specific part is showing the two parallel functions. First function of the tentacle is capturing the prey. The second function is for the locomotion, which means changing the location. We use limbs for changing our body posture and locomotion as well. For example, I'm just riding. So ultimately, like I'm using my limbs, but I'm not locomoting properly. Okay, go through. Now, basically, these above observations will be suggesting that the movement and the locomotion cannot be studied separately. Yes, the movement and the locomotion can't be studied separately. We can't study either locomotion or either movement without going into the other topic. We have to go through, because both of them are linked by stating that all locomotion, do remember I'm underlining, ऑल लोकोमोशन आर मूवमेंट बट ऑल मूवमेंट आर नॉट लोकोमोशन. ओके, ऑल लोकोमोशन आर मूवमेंट बट ऑल मूवमेंट आर नॉट लोकोमोशन, विच मीन्स वेन एवर आई एम चेंजिंग माई पोजिशन और माई लोकेशन फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अदर प्लेस आई एम मूविंग फॉर श्योर, बट आई कैन मूव विदाउट चेंजिंग माई लोकेशन और माई पोजिशन फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू द अदर प्लेस. सो गो थ्रू दैट केस एज वेल. नाउ methods of the locomotion performed by the animal vary with their habitats and the demand of the situation. Do remember one thing, that the plants can't locomote. Okay, so the plants will only move. Okay, they will show movement but they cannot locomote from one place to the other place. Okay, but yes, animals have this specific property to change their location from one place to the other place. That is the reason we can call that the animals can locomote from one place to the other place. However, locomotion is generally for the search of food or for the shelter, for mating purpose, suitable breeding grounds and all, etc., etc., etc. Okay? But the favorable climatic conditions or to escape from the enemies or the predator as well, which means the predator and the prey relationship, which means the tiger and the deer. Tiger and the deer. The predator-prey relationship. Okay, so we can go through as well. Again, locomotion is generally for the search of food, for shelter, mate, suitable breeding ground, or from escaping from the enemies of predator. Okay, or capturing the prey. Now, there are a lot of different types of the movement as well. So here we are dealing that the cells of the human body exhibit three main types of the movement, named as amoeboid, ciliary, and muscular. Named as amoeboid, ciliary and muscular. Okay, go through. Now, some specialized cells in our body like macrophages and leukocytes in blood exhibit the amoeboid movement. Okay, some specialized cell in our body like the macrophages and the leukocytes. So basically like the leukocytes will be the WBCs, and specifically if I'll be going for, it will be the monocytes. Correct? The monocytes. So here we do have the macrophages as well, we have the leukocytes as well, which are showing the amoeboid movement. Now what does this amoeboid movement will be? Somehow like here like the pathogen is, so ultimately they'll be just engulfing the pathogen by means of making a pseudopodia, and the pathogen is within the body of the macrophage. Now this is what we call as the amoeboid movement. This is what we call as the amoeboid movement. And it is basically affected by the pseudopodia formed by the streaming of the protoplasm. We have already gone for, okay, streaming of the protoplasm. We call this as cyclosis. Okay, deal with the case. Now, the cytoskeletal elements like the microfilaments are also involved in the amoeboid movement. Now, what does these microfilaments mean? So basically, they are the actin filaments. Okay, we'll be dealing with this in the next lectures. Now, the ciliary movements. So basically the ciliary movements is occurring in the internal tubular organs of the human as well. Basically these organs are lined by the ciliated epithelium. Somehow like I'm having the here, like this will be the ciliated epithelial cell. The coordinated movement of the cilia and in the trachea is helping in removing the dust particle and some of the foreign substances which have inhaled along with the atmospheric air. So basically this is my trachea, so here the cilia will be present. And if like the dust particle has came here, all of them will be functioning in a coordinated fashion in this direction. So ultimately, this dust particle will be exhaled from the body. Okay, by means of sneezing, by means of spitting or something, by means of the air normal. Okay, go through. The second example will be the passage of the ova. The passage of the ova in the fallopian tube. The passage of ova in the fallopian tube. Okay, the passage of the ova in the fallopian tube in the female reproductive tract. In the female reproductive tract is also facilitated by the ciliary movement. Yes. Okay. We can go through that case. Now, the movement of the limbs, jaws, tongue, etc., 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 does require the muscular movement. So basically, the contractile property of the muscle are effectively used for the locomotion and other movement by the human beings. Now, what are the contractile proteins? So basically, the actin and the myosin are the contractile proteins. The actin and the myosin are contractile proteins. We'll be dealing with the actin and the myosin in detail in the next lectures. So here, for the time being, But the human beings and the majority of the multicellular organism, locomotion does requires a perfect coordinated activity of muscular, skeletal and the neural system. Yes, the muscle as well, the skeletal tissues as well and the neural system as well, all of them, they have to be in a perfect coordinated activity, then only we can walk. Only walking's example I'm taking. Okay, so here, if the muscular, skeletal and the neural system, all of them are working in a coordinated fashion, then only we can walk. So basically, in this lecture series, we'll be learning about the types of the muscle, their structure, the mechanism of their contraction, and the important aspect of the skeletal system. Okay, so hopefully this introductory portion has been beneficial for you guys. Thank you very much for your so much support. I am literally overwhelmed from your support. Please do ask me any questions if you do have in the comment section as well. Thank you.